Hi folks, it's Steve here again, and this is Catalyst number 22, and just want to share something about testimony today. What you have experienced with your journey with God is powerful and effective to influence people. You have something that's uniquely yours, your experience, and you can share it in a way that no one else can. What God has done with you, how he's changed you, how he's grown you, how he's evolved stuff within your life is unique to you, and only you can share it. Sometimes we share secondhand things. Have you heard about so-and-so? Wasn't it a great story? And they're great, and it can encourage people, but there's nothing like sharing what you have got to influence and change other people's lives for the better, and particularly when it comes to kingdom grace over them. When you have something that you share that changes other people's lives, it's powerful and effective. This was particularly something that I just saw again as I was listening to Dan Reynolds. He was over in Bath a couple of weeks ago, and he shared this in his sermon. I'd love you to have a listen and then think about this together. So here's Dan. Have a listen to this.
I was up in the north. Was it north? Norfolk. Yesterday, some of you were there for the celebration of Mike Godward's life. And driving that far, so 4 or 5 hours, on the way up there, we could see petrol stations with long, long lines, with people buying petrol through fear that it might run out. And so we were able to drive there, and we got to the celebration service. And after leaving after a couple of hours, realized we do need petrol. But every petrol station said no more fuel, or the lines were so long, or if you actually joined the line, after a while, it was only diesel that was left, and the car we had borrowed wasn't a diesel car. And so we thought, we'll be fine, we'll find one. And we just kept driving. We hit the motorway, and every service station, it said, no more fuel, no more fuel. And you look at your GPS and you realize, look at how many miles it is back to Bath. And then you look on the digital display and how many miles you have left in the tank. And they didn't add up. We fell short of about 60 miles. So Fee's praying in tongues and thank you, Lord. And you can tell as we got a little bit closer to no answer, the prayers got a little more intense. And then my planning mind's like, okay, what will we actually do if we run out or we have to park up? It's Saturday. We won't be able to go to the meeting in the morning. And this is, where will we sleep? And how will we tow? This is a borrowed car. All these things are coming in my mind. And I thought, you know what? Let's get off the motorway and go to a town off the motorway, and no one else will think of that. So we pulled off and we drove about 15 minutes into this town, and we drove around Tesco, no more fuel. We drove a little further, no more fuel. Lines, people, and as you could just driving around, people doing U-turns, the look of hopelessness in people's faces. And we found one more place that we could see. It was a Morrison's, and we could see that there was a sign for petrol in the distance. And as we joined the line and got closer and closer, I could see that as people were getting to the petrol pump, they were turning around and coming back. And as they were driving past, the look of hopelessness was on their face. So I kept inching forward, looking at my clock. What are we going to do? And when we finally got close to the pump, it said, no more fuel. And so we joined everybody else in turning back. Everyone say, turning back. And we began to drive, I don't know where, because we couldn't go back to the motorway. What do we do? Do we look for a hotel? Do we rent a car? What, do we get an Uber? Do we get a taxi? What do we do with Fee's parents' car? All these things. And suddenly Fee began to pray, Lord, thank you for fuel. Thank you for petrol. And as you know, faith started to come rise in my heart. And I said, we're going to go back. And she said, but there's no more fuel. I said, there must be fuel. And I drove through Morrison's car park and I went to the back and there was some guys there washing cars. And I said, hey guys, where can we get fuel? And he smiled. He said, go round the back of the pump. There's no one there. And there's fuel there. I said, okay, thanks, mate. Drove round, pulled up to a pump, no one there, put it in, and it filled up. I'm like, this is amazing. So then, we've got a full tank of fuel, and I went back, and as we slowly drove through all the people that were going through the same process we did 5 minutes ago, with a look of terror, which became hopelessness, and then they had to turn around. We opened our window and said, go across there, drive across the back. They were like, and their face lit up and they turned the other way and went where we instructed. He said, you can't tell everybody. I was like, I just want to tell everybody. So we went from one car, go the other way. And so people at the back are now turning around and cutting across the parking lot to get to the gas, petrol. As we drove away full, I thought, that's really a picture of the world right now. There is a feeling of hopelessness, and there's a feeling of terror. What will we do? Taking little things for granted. And suddenly, it alters everything. And I wanted to tell you this morning, church. We have a fuel that never, ever runs out. And it's a fuel that is on the inside of us. Jesus said, there is a river, and anyone who's thirsty can come and drink, and streams, watch this, streams of living water will flow from within.
Wasn't that good? It's just amazing how you can be in the right place at the right time, and God can influence you, and you can pray into a situation, and it changes everything, and takes you deeper, and then you start sharing that with other people, and it changes their lives. That's what I want for this week. I want us to be just considering what God has done for us. What has he done for you? How has he changed your life? How has he, when you dug in, what has God done? And then how has that impacted other people? Share it with the people in your group, with your friends, your neighbors, your family, and let's be a difference in our world today. Catch you next time.